I do live a very slutty lifestyle. The other day, I looked down at my stuff, and there was stuff on my stuff. It's not supposed to be on my stuff. And I lost my mind. And I called my partner. I was like, I've got herpes. Our life is over. I'm sorry. And they're like, it's fine. Just go get tested. We'll figure it out. And the place that I like was closed. So I drove across town. And I got there right as they were closing. And I walked into the nurse. And I'm like, hey, there's stuff on my stuff that's not supposed to. Can you look at? I need someone to see my stuff and look at my stuff. And the nurse was like, what? And I was like, there's just, can you look at, I need someone to look at the stuff. And like, do you want a doctor to look at? And I was like, yes, perfect, thank you. And I went in a room and a doctor came in and he was like, oh, that's not herpes, you're fine. That's just like a skin thing. And I was like, hell yeah, tight, thank you, thank you. I know you didn't do it, but thank you. Thank you for this gift that you've given to me. But I was like, I haven't been tested in a little bit. So the next morning I went to the place that I do like and I saw a new doctor there who was the oldest man maybe alive. And I walk into his office and he's blasting aggressive classical music from a phone on his desk, which is a weird doctor's office atmosphere to stumble into. And I take my pants off and I'm like, it's just like a skin thing. And he's like, that's herpes. What? I was like, for sure though, what if it isn't though, huh? What if it's not? What if it's just a skin thing, as I've been told before? And he's like, well, check this out. And he pulls out what I can only describe as a scrapey boy, just the scrapiest boy, the scrapiest boy that ever did scrape. And he starts scraping, and it's bad. It hurts very much. And he's scraping, and at one point he stops, and he's like, huh. And I'm like, huh? And he's like, huh. And I'm like, what's huh? And he's like, well, if this were herpes, I could break it open.
Oh, Jesus.
But I can't. And I'm like, okay, what is that? And he's like, yeah, I don't think this is herpes. And I'm like, word. And he's like, I think it's just a skin thing. Oh, cool, like what I said when I came, thank you for confirming with your second opinion. And he's like, I really want to break it open though. I was like, you have to stop. You are not allowed any longer. And I pull my pants back up, which hurts itself because of what he's done. And he looks at me and he's like, well, you know what you should do? You should get a circumcision. I'm 30. It's like, no, I'm not. Also, and he's like, well, it's just like it's a problem with the skin. Take that skin right off. Oh. Just not a solution that any other skin trouble has ever been offered. Oh, you got a rash on your shoulder? Lop that arm off, baby. You don't need that. But also, like, I can't help but just imagine, like, me in a waiting room, and it's just babies in there with me. I'm like, hey, you know if this guy's any good? I looked on Yelp, but all the reviews just said goo goo ga ga. 4 stars. Why not 5? It's a 1-person applause break. Thank you, I'll take it. 1 enthusiastic clapper.